6 o'clock was perfectly fine. At 7:30, wait a minute, this wind is really picking up. Then the wind was so strong, it just lifted me up in the air. Early the next morning, and when we looked outside, it was a totally different world. This is really a catastrophe.
Mr. President, I come to you straight from the front line of the war on climate change. With physical and emotional difficulty, I have left my bleeding nation to be with you here today, because these are the moments for which the United Nations exist.
The first days, you don't know where to begin. There's so much to do. I was really shocked. Although we are used to having the storms pass, and for our generation so far, none of them can surpass this one.
There's no 911 call you can dial. You have to think, right at the moment, what am I going to do to survive?
Right across the island, we're actually in the Prime Minister's office broadcasting to you now because they have a generator and they've kindly allowed us to work out of here. I've been to a lot of disasters, I've covered a lot of war zones. It is really bad here. There's not a building, it seems, in this country that has not been touched. Every tree has either been knocked to the ground or had the foliage stripped off it. Three of the four bridges that come into the capital here from the airport.
I can understand why folks leave, and I think some should leave. But there are some folks who need to stay, and I think I'm one of those who needs to stay.
We were at the airport yesterday, and it was sad. I saw some friends, family members, and it was sad seeing them leaving because you thought that you would never see them again. And some of the young kids, that's our future, that's our hope, and they're leaving with an image on their minds of a destruction, and they would not want to come back to a place like that. It was not a happy scene.
We started our school. My youngest son then was 3 years old and just began teaching him. Then I just told my husband, I think I should invite some other children to come too. Then other people started coming in. Taught all of them to read, to write, to do everything. And then I saw, and saw the school. It's sad. It's just so sad.
Brand new, never used. Just got them. Never used.
No, we lost the school, but God is still good. He can supply. I'm not going to run away. I'll stand and see, finish the work that I started. Love to finish it.
This is not a short-term, one-day, one-week thing. When we look at the way this our island has been hit, it looks like we've been put back to the 70s.
Take my detergent, take off the leaves.
The old infrastructure is damaged so badly, but we'd love to stay. We'd love to stay to help rebuild. If you sit down and wait, you'll be waiting for weeks. You'll be still waiting. So we had to make things happen. We're working with different persons, especially my brothers, who have contacted individuals overseas. Very concerned citizens, they have decided that they're going to do whatever they can to help. But yesterday was the first time I was online, and it was amazing. Family and friends had no idea that we were alive. They didn't know what was going on. We didn't know what was going on.
I saw this as a category 5 storm.
I had no idea that Maria was a category 5.
I'm down. I carried all of those. Okay, I gotta go.
Right. Wow. Thank God. The need is great. Everyone needs food. And whatever we have, we see, okay, if there's a person who needs, we take what we have and we share with them.
Look at these folks. Huh? Mr. Barry, oh my.
Oh, it's broken.
Yes.
The complete top.
The top went, so, yeah.
Fell down, just fell in. All everything is
all the top.
Yes.
One day at a time, Mr. Barry. I will see.
All right then.
Take care. Right. The last time you heard from.
I have learned that things don't matter in this life. Things are just things. Life is more important. We could have died.
While there may be promises of good nations coming in to help, we're looking at a situation that is not going to be back to normal in 6 months.
I'm supposed to get something. When I get something more, I'll come back. You peel it and put salt.
I think we must be self-sufficient. We learned to live off the land. We have a lot of free trees. We had avocados surrounding the house. We have limes. We have coconuts, bananas, plantains. And we have local teas, bush, we can just use, that are good for medicines too. Nothing in here.
I'm not terrified, or I would not give up.
Buen provecho.
Well, we like to say ladies first.
What will the future be like? Can we make it here? So take one day at a time. Lifestyles will be altered, but there's a fighting spirit of not giving up,